Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and in today's video I'll be talking about detanning. So detanning is a procedure in which you try to protect yourself from getting tan, or you try to reduce your tan. So first of all, we'll see what actually tan means. So when our original skin complexion turns into more of a brownish tone, that's exactly when you have got tanned. So a person gets tan when their skin is exposed to the sun more than the particular amount that it's supposed to get exposed. So we all need sun to our skin for giving us good amount of vitamin D. But when it's over the limit, we start getting tan, and it's really harmful because the sun rays can burn our skin, they can cause a lot of allergies, and we can have a lot of skin diseases if we are exposed too much to the sun. So the first step that your skin is getting reacted because of the harmful sun rays is when you're getting tanned. So tanning doesn't just happen to your face, it happens to all the parts of your body that are exposed to the sun, be it your hands, legs, or anything. So there are a lot of products that are available which can protect your skin from getting tanned, and we should know what to use and when to use. So very important, the first product is using a sunscreen. I use this sunscreen, it's called Episoft. Now this is like a sunscreen mixed with a moisturizer. So I don't have to use two products on my skin, I have two in one. And the best part about this is that it has SPF 30, it's very lightweight, and since I have this extremely sensitive dry skin, I got this by the recommendation of my dermatologist. So if you're someone who has not a normal skin, then it's very good that you buy a sunscreen checking with your dermatologist, otherwise you could just get one which is available in the market. I use my sunscreen 30 minutes before leaving my house because it takes a while for the product to settle in and then get activated. If you use your sunscreen exactly before leaving your house, then what's gonna happen is when you're exposed to the sun, only the product is going to settle in, but it's not gonna work. So the purpose for which you're applying is not going to happen until you don't let the product settle in and get it activated. So I always personally recommend everyone I know to use the product 30 minutes before leaving the house. So there are like a lot of other products that can help you from getting tan. For example, you can protect yourself by using an umbrella when you go out in the sun. You can use a cap, or if you're driving a two-wheeler, you can use a helmet. So the normal helmets is not something that's going to protect you, but rather those which have a plastic front. So they cover the entire face, and that will protect the sun rays from falling on to your skin. Now often tan is misunderstood with dirt, because even when dirt settles onto your skin, it turns into more of a brownish complexion. So doing a face wash thrice a day, especially when you come home from being exposed to the sun, or when you're like absolutely sweaty or anything, and following this 3-time face wash routine will actually let you know if your skin is exposed to the sun too much and that's why you're tan, or it's the dirt which is settled into that color. So as dirt keeps getting settled in, it also turns more into a brownish complexion on your skin. So first try to differentiate whether you're actually tan or whether it's the dirt that's making your skin color change. Sometimes it's not just the skin that gets suntan, but it's also your hair. So if you're someone who's facing a lot of hair damage, hair fall, because your hair is exposed a lot to the sun, then I'm going to tell you a super quick product that's just going to help you recover this hair damage. It's aloe vera. So you can either get like a ready-made aloe vera, or if you have an aloe vera plant in your house, you can just remove the pulp, mix it quickly into a thin fine paste, and just apply it on your hair, and then have a normal hair wash. So aloe vera helps you revive your hair back to its normal state, and it reduces your hair fall, it protects your hair damage, and it's like a sunscreen for your hair. So there is some easy DIY homemade masks that can help you from getting tanned. Now there are like a lot of masks that we can see online, or we can see a lot of bloggers telling us, and a lot of things like that, where they use potato, gram flour, and so many products. But I'm going to tell you two easy masks which involve only two products each and give super quick results, or I can say they can help you revive from your tan. So the first one is honey and lemon. So 1 tablespoon of honey with 1/2 lime squeezed and mixed thoroughly, apply to all your parts which are exposed to the sun or which are tan for like 15 15 minutes every day will help you from recovering your tan. If you're someone who is not exposed to the sun often, you can use this mask maybe like once or twice a week, depending on how much you go into the sun. The second mask is for those people who go into water. So I had a question being asked if you get water tanned. So there's a misconception where people are thinking that it's water that makes you tan, but that's not true. It's the sun rays that fall on you when you are in water that make you tan. So if you see like the indoor swimming pools, you don't get tan in those, but the outdoor ones you get tan because the sun rays are falling on you when you are in water. So to protect yourself from that, you can either use a sunscreen before going into water, or there's this simple DIY mask that can help you. All that you have to do is take a tomato and a bowl of yogurt. This yogurt should not be the ready-made one, but the homemade yogurt. So just make a paste of these two by putting it in the mixer and then apply it to all the parts that are exposed to, you know, when you're going into the pool, and that's it. You can just let it be there again for 15 minutes and then just have a normal bath, and then that's gonna work as your mask or as your sunscreen when you're going into the water. So it's as simple as that. And the best tip that I can give you for protecting yourself from getting tanned or not letting your skin get more tanned is by not going out in the sun during the sunny hours. So if you have to go, like have to go somewhere out during the sun hours, then don't forget to use these masks, use these products, and protect yourself from getting tanned. If the tan is not treated at the right time, the tan can even be permanent, where nothing can help the tan come out, and that'll settle in and it would look like your permanent skin complexion. So that is it for today's video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you really liked it, please subscribe to my channel and share this video, and I'll see you guys next time.